In this lesson, we're going to review some of the basic concepts of products. In Regpack, anything you offer your applicants that has a price associated with it, and even some that don't, is considered a product. Since you'll be working with products a lot, we've created a separate spot for them, which you can get to by clicking Settings, Products. Let's take a look around. This page is organized similarly to the form page, so you'll want to divide your products into categories. To create a category, click Create New Category, give it a name, keep in mind your applicants will see this name, and click Create Category. You noticed some other options. You can come back to update these at any time by mousing over the category and clicking the pencil. This category holds substitute products means that an applicant can only select one of the options in a category, and this is a mandatory category means that in order for the product selection form to be marked complete, they must select at least one option from that category. Top and bottom comments are just optional text descriptions which you can include, and they'll show up either below the category name or below all the products in a category. Once you have your categories set, you can reorder them by clicking Actions, Order Categories, and then dragging to adjust the order. And you can drag products to new categories, or select multiple products, click Actions, and click the name of the category you'd like to move them to. We'll cover the specifics of setting up individual products later, but for now, I want us to take a step back and look at the big picture. The products page is the control room, and from here, you'll control what the products are and who should see them. Then the applicants see the products on whichever form a product selection widget is placed, at which point they'll be able to order any of the products you allowed them to see. Once they've ordered a product, the products show up in the applicant's cart. You can access an applicant's cart in the backend on the user management page, and you control whether applicants can edit the products in their cart during the course of their registration. Once your applicants have ordered their products, you'll be able to do reporting in various locations. And at the end of a product's life cycle, you can either hide them, if you'd like to keep it for later reporting, delete them, deliver them, which will archive all paid-for products in your applicant's cart, or even just move on to a brand new version of the project, leaving the previous years untouched. And that's the life cycle of a product. I hope this helped break down some of the big concepts, and as always, feel free to contact support at regpacks.com if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.